See, the free will is the divine grace. If you use it towards the divine, you will be given more free will. The effort and the grace is one and the same. The effort and the grace is one and the same. Understand this small example. A cow, if it is tied with a 5-meter rope in a pole, inside that 5-meter, the cow can sit, stand, or eat the grass, sleep. It has got free will. But more than that 5-meter, it has no free will. But if the cow behaves properly inside that 5-meter, the rope length can be extended or totally it can be set free. Same way, the free will which you have in your hand, a small amount of free will, if you put towards an effort to do the spiritual practice, the free will be increased. So naturally you will have more effort. The divine will grace you through the free will, which can in turn be increased as a more effort. The more effort, more grace. The more grace, more effort. It just becomes a circle to reach, to make you towards the enlightenment. So, if you have the will to do practice, understand the first grace of the divine has descended on you. The first ray of grace of divine has descended on you. Put your effort and start doing, you will see, you will be more and more showered by divine grace. The very feeling, very idea, very clarity to start traveling the spiritual path comes to you only when the divine grace descends on you, not before that.
During the last ASPI interval, I received a card containing a quotation to dissolve from time into timelessness, earth into worthlessness, from matter into energy. To experience the divine.
Yes. Now you experience the whole world just as a matter, only as a matter. But not only the mystics. Now, after Einstein, even the physics scientists have very clearly declared there is no such thing as matter exists on the universe. Everything is energy. The first batch of scientists, they declared in atom there is one particle which is matter, another one is energy. After the next batch, they declared no, same particle is matter at particular time, energy in the next moment. Next, now they say the quantum physics, it is matter and energy at the same time. There is no even time-space gap. It is simply energy. It is simply energy. Understand? The idea of matter enters into you as long as you think you are matter. As long as you identify yourself with the body, you think the existence is also matter. Once you experience the glimpse of the energy in you, you will understand the whole thing is energy. For example, when you look at a rose early in the morning, you stop. The moment you look at the rose, immediately the rose god appears in your mind. Next will be all the roses which you have given to somebody, presented to somebody. All the roses presented to you, that memory. Third, how you behaved or how she behaved. Fourth, whether love or hatred related to that incident. Slowly, the thinking will go on. You will forget the real rose which is here. That is what usually happens in our mind. The moment you start verbalizing, you miss what is reality. Your mind goes somewhere. You are somewhere else. Try this simple experiment. Sit with some tree or with some plant or some thing, don't use the name. If it is rose plant, don't use the word rose bush. It is beautiful. Don't use all those words. Drop all the words. It's looking nice. It's colorful. Don't use all those words. Drop all the words. Just see, as if a child sees how he looks. Only after 3 years your verbalization starts. Below 3, you don't have verbalization. If a child sees how he or she will see. When a child sees, he looks through his whole being. That is why you can see their eyes so bubbling, so alive. There is no words inside. Now for us, half our mind is creating words. In Patanjali, there is a beautiful word called Ojas. Means, you need to understand. Many people ask me, Swamiji, how when we listen to your discourse, we forget the time? How it happens? We are just sitting. How our mind is so concentrated? One important thing you should understand, when I speak, if I have the inner chattering, when you hear, you will also have inner chattering. When I speak, if I don't have two mind, if I am total, you also have to listen totally. Automatically your mind will become one. If I am double, if I am 2%, you will also be 2%. If I am single, naturally you will become single. When you are single, without having two things, seeing and verbalizing, the rose also will start looking in a different way. Now, because you are doubled, one is seeing, another one is verbalizing. With kids, two things never happens. They don't verbalize. They just see. Just like a child, look freshly, directly, without words. Don't use all your knowledge about rose bush. Don't use all your analysis about rose. Don't use all those things. Just look directly, simply, without knowing about the words, about the brand, about the color. All those things are just foolishness. Just yesterday, we have been to Fossil Green. All those animals, to see all those animals. Some of the devotees were with me. Continuously they are analyzing the brochure. What is the name? From which country and all those things. Of course, I was just feeling, just seeing itself is so much. I never felt like asking their name or which country, all those these that details. When you intensely feel that itself is more than enough, when they tell the name, all right, okay, but even though knowing the name, what are we going to do? What are you going to do? Nothing. If you enjoy the scene, that's enough, over. It is for the people who do research, for them to know the name, age and all those things. From which country, these, that, details. For us, just the scene, how beautiful, over. When you look at the rose plant, instead of bringing words about the plant in your mind, just look. If a child looks, how he will look, how she will look, in that same way look. Don't allow any thoughts. Look deeply. You will see that rose is a living energy just like you. You will feel the same energy which you feel inside you into that rose. If you master this technique only once if you master this technique with the rose, you can relate with anything and feel it is energy. It is not matter. You can relate with stone, you can relate with the tree, you can relate with moon, you can relate with sun, you can relate with idols and feel their gods, their energies, not matter. So only once you know that knack or technique to relate with the existence without words, you will dissolve matter into energy. You will experience matter into energy. You will start feeling it's a living beings. Ramakrishna says, when I do the Kali Puja, sometimes if I get a doubt whether it is a Vigraha or whether it is a just idol or Devi, I will take a thread and keep near her nose to see whether she is breathing or not. Always thread used to move because of our inhaling and exhaling. He says because of our inhaling and exhaling, thread used to move. When you know a simple technique of having a glimpse, one glimpse of relating with the divine without words, then you will know how to dissolve the matter into energy. Then your whole life is just energy. There is nothing called matter on the planet Earth, on the universe, because universe is energy. Existence is energy. That's what we say in the Upanishads. Prajnana Brahma. Intelligence is existence. The whole existence is intelligence. It is not a dead matter. It's a prajna. It's a living existence. When you realize the whole thing is energy, you will understand it's a living existence. Prajna Brahma. Thank you.
You mentioned about suffering. Suffering, you look at, you have mental suffering, you have physical suffering. Is there unity in suffering? And you said that you should get rid of your ego and hence you reduce suffering. But some of us, we have a lot of physical suffering. How do you overcome that?
It's a wonderful question. But sorry to be truthful. Sometimes truth hurts. It is our ego which invites even physical suffering. Let you understand a little deeply. Ramana Maharshi was questioned by one of his disciples. Ramana Maharshi had a cancer in his last phase of his life. Somebody questioned him, "Bhagwan, are you suffering?" He says, "There is a pain, but not suffering. There is a pain, but no suffering." It's a little intricate thing to understand. When you have the attitude to attract the pain, attract the suffering, you create more and more sufferings in you. More and more pain in you. The mental setup which attracts the pain, which attracts the suffering, is what I call ego. There is a particular mental setup which we may call it as karma, but I don't want to use that big word. I call it mental setup. That mental setup is one of the important reasons for all our even physical sufferings. Every pain has got its own emotional root. According to the Puranas, even the accidents are your own guests. You invite them. Even the accidents. One important thing you should understand, when I say it may look like a story, it may look like a tale, when you look little deeply, to analyze, when you look little deeply into the mind, you will be able to understand there can be nothing on the planet Earth which is not having any cause. There can be no coincidence in the planet Earth. Can you say anything happens without cause? Everything happens only with the cause and effect. Only with the cause there is an effect. When you don't understand the link between cause and effect, you say it is coincidence or miracle. When you don't understand the link, when you understand the link between cause and effect, you say it is logical. When you are not able to understand the cause and effect, if it happens in some higher plane or lower plane, if it happens in lower plane, you say coincident. If it happens in higher plane, you say miracle. But in the planet Earth, there can be nothing. There can't be anything. There can't be anything on the planet Earth which has no cause. Anything has to have cause. Unless there is a cause, effect can never happen. Can you say something can happen without cause? No. One important theory, now they are coming up with this theory in physics field. If an atom is moving here, in some other part of the world, the same atom is happening in a different, if it is moving here from here to here, there to here. Then if it is from east to west here, there it is from west to east. No movement is just a silent, independent movement on the planet Earth. They are coming up with a new theory in the physics. No movement, no effect is without cause, or no cause goes without effect. If you look little deeply, all our physical, not only physical diseases, even the accidents we invite, the problem is, it is so unconscious, the mental thinking, the 90% of our thinking happens so unconsciously, we are not able to find or connect the cause and the effect. Just understand one thing, you are here now because of all your past decisions. You decided to hear about me coming, and then you decide to get the more information. Then you decide to take your car and drive. Then you decide to stop your car here. Then you decide to come in and sit. Then you decide to continue to sit. The totality of all these decisions only is making you to sit here. Totality of all these past decisions are your present moment. That is it. That is your present moment. The present totality of present decisions will be your future. That is what is whole karma theory. Totality of all your past is present. Totality of your present will be your future. The problem is, most of the decisions we take unconsciously. There are so many thousands of decisions we take unconsciously. That is the reason you are not able to connect the cause and the effect. Flood more awareness, more intelligence into your thinking system. Flood more awareness, more consciousness into your decision-making system. People ask me, Swamiji, how do we take birth? Who decides our life? I tell you, it is you who decide even your life. It is you who decide even your body. You may think, what are you talking, Swamiji? Whether you believe or not, whether you accept or not, whether you understand or not, there are few truths, they are truths. They may not have become facts by scientific research, but they are truths. Even before Newton discovered gravitation theory, gravity was there. Am I right? Before Newton also, apples were falling down. Do you think before Newton, apples were going up? No. Before Newton also, apples were falling down. Before Newton, gravitation was a truth. After Newton, it has become a fact. He made it as a clear fact and figures. Same way, there are the few truths. They have not yet become facts. They are truths, but they are yet to become fact. These are the few things. They are truths yet to become fact. Important thing, including your body, you create with your mind, with your ego, with your structure. Krishna says, the last moment of your demise, what is your thought? That is only going to decide what is your next birth. It's a very important thing to understand. Last moment, what you think, that only is going to decide what is your next birth. Actually, when you die, when you leave the body, your whole life will come in a small fast forward form, in a condensed form. You will see your whole life in a condensed way, in a very short way, just in few minutes, the whole thing will come. So all your peak experiences will come up. All your peak experiences in the life will pop up. You will see all the peak experiences if you have lived throughout your life just by eating. Naturally, what will you think? Anyhow, even if I take one more body, I am going to eat. Let us take a body which is very comfortable for eating. Which is the best body for eating? Pig, naturally. Pig. Now really, this is the way you decide. This is the logic you use and decide. You see the totality of your peak experiences. Based on that, you design your own body. If you have spent all your life just in eating, you take pig birth, next body. If you have spent all your life just by sleeping, lethargic way, you take buffalo body. That's the best way to be. Lethargic, no responsibility. Have you seen a single buffalo going for a regular job? They don't have to pay bills. They don't have to bring their kids up. They don't have to bother anything else. And they don't even have a depression problem. They don't go to psychiatrist. Have you seen a single buffalo who is going to psychiatrist? No. Nothing is necessary. There is no responsibility. When you don't have responsibility, you can slip totally, be lethargic. So when you don't take any responsibility, when you don't create, if you have spent your whole life just in a lethargic way, if your father is a wealthy guy, if he hands over all the wealth to you, there is every chance for you to take the next janma as a buffalo. Because when your father creates and leaves it to you, you do not know the value. You do not know the value. I always tell people, never give property to your son. If you hate him, then give property. If you want that he should be distraught, then give property. Otherwise, give courage, responsibility, intelligence, and help him to stand on his own. Only then he will know the value. He will know the value. Even if you are going to give property, don't give as long as you are alive. Never give. Because you see, when you are alive, even if something wrong happens, even if he does something wrong, you will be there to protect him. So let him learn how to stand up, how to stand on his own feet. Let him understand, let him become responsible when you are alive. If you give naturally, he will never learn the intricacies. See, Lakshmi will stay only when you create. Never if it simply comes. There are thousands of survey reports which says, research reports which says, nobody maintains the money which they get through lottery. Nobody maintains the money which they get through lottery. There are survey reports which proves very clearly, more than 90% of the people lose the money within a year. Because maintain Lakshmi is not a joke. You need tremendous intelligence to maintain Lakshmi. So it's the intelligence based on which you desire your body. If you live just for eating, then know your what is going to be your janma. If you live just sleeping, know what is going to be your janma. It is your setup, it is your mental decision which decides even your body. According to me, your disease is also nothing but your own investments. Please forgive me if I hurt you. But sometimes truth hurts. Truth hurts. Every disease, you have some investment. Go deep into the mental setup and analyze. You may need, see, even the attention need makes you fall sick. Especially in this country, nobody gives attention to others. Everybody is busy. Everybody is busy in their routine. So if you want attention, what kids do? They put the blanket and say, "Mom, I am not feeling well." Immediately, you are attended. Immediately, you are attended. That is why you create your own disease for so many other reasons. Even the attention need creates the diseases. And there's a new thing coming up, Monday blow-ups. Have you heard of that? Monday blow-ups. People get cardiac arrest. People get heart attack Monday morning, in Monday mornings. Anyhow, so all these things, look, you can directly relate them to your mind, to your mental setup, and 90% of the psychosomatic diseases are from your mental setup. So if you look little deep, you invite a guest, not only you simply invite, you give a phone call, you leave voice message, then you send a mail, finally you send a fax, and then finally you send somebody with a flight ticket and get him. The moment he enters your house, you say, "Oh, I told you to bring somebody else, you brought him." Only the moment he enters your house, you understand it's a wrong person. You did not call the right person. You say, "Oh, I have not called you." Same way, all your diseases are your guests. You invite him. You do everything to get him. But finally you say, "Oh, I have not done anything. I have not called. Swamiji, what is this?" You say, "I have called my disease. How will I call?" Small story. A guy entered into McDonald's. Had enough of stuff. Ate all the possible things. I'm surprised to see such big Coca-Cola bottles. In India, even cows won't drink so much water. I'm surprised. Such big Coca-Cola bottles and stuff. The coffee is cheap. Oh, Baba. And burgers they build like houses. Anyhow, after finishing everything, he received a bill. He said, "I haven't ordered for it." You see, you don't order for bill, but it always comes to you. It is the effect of the cause which you created. So can you say, no, "I have not ordered for bill, it has come"? No. You may not order for disease, but you created all the causes. So naturally effect has to happen. If you look little deep and analyze, you can understand every disease, every physical pain, every emotional pain is related to some part of your mental setup. The chakras. Every emotion is related to some chakra. For example, stomach is related to, the navel chakra is related to Orient depression. You can always see any news which you can't bear or digest, if it comes to you, the The first blow will be for stomach. Either you will have stomach upset or diarrhea. Am I right? How many of you have experienced? You see, anything which gives you shock, the first blow will be for your stomach, because navel chakra is related to worrying and depression. Every chakra is related to some emotion. Of course, this is what we are going to deal in the Ananda Spurana program, this 2-day meditation workshop. The emotions related to every chakra will be analyzed, and a particular meditation to cleanse and awaken that chakra. You will undergo the 7 different meditation techniques to cleanse all the 7 chakras. It's a 36 hours program. Every chakra is related to some emotion. If you use that emotion, that chakra opens, you get the benefit, help from it. If you abuse that emotion, that gets locked and you suffer from it. You abuse your emotions, you abuse your being, you abuse your mind without knowing. Unconsciously, there starts the whole trouble. If you know how to use, you will not only escape from the disease, you will have a positive well-being, which is beyond the word health. Health is just a word. No diseaseness, but there is something more, positive well-being, a bubbling living energy. So, if you look little deep, the whole thing is just your own creation. You attract, you invite. It's like a dish attracting the satellite signals. Your pain body attracts more pain. Your ego attracts more suffering to itself. Because in the planet Earth, every being has got his own instinct to survive. Just like that, your ego also has got its own instinct to survive. The instinct to survive creates more pain, more suffering, so that it can live more strongly on your being. Let you understand this and come out of it, experience the bliss, eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.